Namaste and hello everyone. Welcome back to my channel, Hamsavahini Vajraasthra. I'm Awhona. In today's video, I'm here to make a quick announcement about the Nightingale August Challenge Readathon. Now, the Nightingale August Challenge Readathon was created as a tribute to Florence Nightingale as well as the global nursing healthcare services. However, this year, it does include a couple of fun elements as well as a section on Victorian medical healthcare as well. So it does have a slight gothic touch to it to make it just a bit more fun. So to know more, do please join me further in this video. For you. Now, the only requirement for participation is that you need to read two books. The first is a non-fiction book about Florence Nightingale or any aspect of her life, and the second is a nursing fiction book which is inspired by Florence Nightingale, or which has Florence Nightingale as the main protagonist, or which has the word Nightingale in its title, or where the protagonist is somehow going to be working with Florence Nightingale or is related with Florence Nightingale in any way. So these are the only two books which you need to read for participation. However, if you would like to explore more and if you would like to have some fun, you definitely can try out those challenges. Now, I have the challenges written in front of me, and there is no hard and fast rule that you need to do the challenges. You can just pick up one challenge if you would like, or you can try as many challenges as you want, or that is in case if you would like to have some fun, or if you would like to know a little more about the Victorian medical history. So for ease of convenience, I have tried to divide the challenges into three broad sections. So the first is the history section. So challenge number one is to read a book about the medical health care during the Victorian age, which may also include asylums and madhouses. So there is no compulsion that it has to be only nursing health services. It could broadly have even the experiences of the doctors, or the challenges which were faced by the doctors during the Victorian age, or the epidemics which were breaking out, or it could also deal with the children's healthcare services, because that was a very neglected area. It could also deal with childbirth, which was quite a challenging arena during the Victorian age, and there are lots of superstitions which were associated with it. So you could just read anything about the medical history of the Victorian age, and it has to be broadly within the Victorian period. So it could be a few years here and there, but the main chunk of it should be within the Victorian age. So that was the first challenge. Now the second challenge is to read a book written by Florence Nightingale. So I will be sharing a few recommendations with you later on in another video for this particular challenge. Now the third challenge is to read a book about a predecessor, a contemporary, or an immediate successor of Florence Nightingale. So I have listed out a couple of them in the in this particular readathon. So you could just read a biography or any book which is related to any of them, or in case if you do find an immediate predecessor or an immediate successor or another contemporary which are not mentioned in this list, you definitely can try and check or bring in a book about that as well. So the first is a predecessor of Florence Nightingale, and that is Dorothy Dix. Now Dorothy Dix was a nurse who was devoted to evolving the ways in which the patients at the madhouses and asylums were being handled. So there's a lot which is written about her, and this would be the first nurse whom I would recommend you could read about. So you could just read about a biography on her or anything which is related to her. And the second is a contemporary of Florence Nightingale, who is Mary Seacole. Now as we know, Mary Seacole was a famous Jamaican British doctress, and she was not allowed to work with Florence Nightingale due to various rules which were being imposed. So she set out herself to serve the soldiers, or the wounded soldiers in the Crimean War and in the battlefield. So she has written some work, some of her works as well, and some of her experiences. So you can write something which is you can read something which is written by her, or you can read something written about her. So that would be Mary Seacole. The second contemporary is Clara Barton. Now, as we all know, Clara Barton was the co-founder of the American Red Cross, and she contributed hugely in the American Civil War, and she was in correspondence with Florence Nightingale. So you can read a biography of Clara Barton, or you can read anything written by Clara Barton, or you can read anything written about the life of Clara Barton. And then we also have another contemporary, who was Sarah Emma Edmonds, who was one of the famous nurse spies of the American Civil War. And although she was not exactly in direct correspondence with Florence Nightingale, but yes, she was trained as a nurse during that period of time. And then we also have Edith Cavell. Now, Edith Cavell was a successor of Florence Nightingale. And apart from that, we also have Linda Richards and Violetta Thurston, who were successors of Florence Nightingale. So you could read a biography or anything which is related to them. And in case if there are other contemporary successors or predecessors whom you may know of, or if you find any books on them, you definitely can introduce them in your TBR. So those are all the list of predecessors, successors, and contemporaries that I could find. You have to read any one book on them, or you could just read one book which has all of them in it. So I will be sharing a couple of book recommendations in a later video. Now let's get down to the next set of challenges. Now the next set is called real life experiences. So challenge number 4 is to read a book about the contributions or experience of a modern day nurse. So you could select any book which encompasses nurses in training, or nurses who were facing the challenges during the pandemic, or you could read about the encounters of a male nurse, or you could read a book about school nurses. So anything is absolutely welcome. Then challenge number 5 is to read a book about paramedics and their real life experiences. And challenge number 6 is to read a book about real life paranormal encounters at the hospital, or about haunted hospitals. So these have to be absolutely real life, and there is no hard and fast rule in this challenge that it has to be only the encounters by nurses. It could be encounters by doctors or by patients as well. So as long as it's a haunted hospital and a paranormal experience and a real life one. So that is all about the real life experience section. The last section is the fiction section. So there are only two challenges listed in it. So the seventh challenge is to read any fiction about nurses, and challenge number eight is to read about any medical horror fiction or fiction about haunted hospitals. So these are the eight challenges. It is not a mandate that you have to participate in the challenges. You can do so if you want to have fun, and you can just try any challenge from any section. You can double up or triple up on any of the books, as long as you would like to enjoy these challenges. So those are all the challenges and the participation requirements which are for this particular readathon. Now I would also like to mention that last year in the Nightingale August challenge, I did have Janelle from Too Fond of Books participating in it, and she did make a wonderful selection of books, and I have posted a link to her videos in the description box below. There are a few book recommendations which I have done in my last year's announcement videos as well, so you can definitely check on them. But there is a bit of a difference in the challenges from last year. So because last year I did focus on the Crimean War more, but this year I have focused on the Victorian medical history more. So that's all I have for today, and do please let me know if you would like to participate, and what you think about this particular readathon. And with that, I'll be wrapping up this video. I will see you very soon again with another video. Hopefully it should be the recommendations video for this particular readathon. So till then, take care, have a good reading week ahead, and namaste.